Scotland has long been a favorite location to teach and learn field geology skills. Yet with the combination of bogs and mountains, jagged coastlines, and rainy weather, the captivating landscape presents challenges for geology students with mobility impairments. We are traveling with a group of 12 students of diverse physical ability to explore the potential of accessible field learning in locations commonly used for geology field exercises.
We're here just looking at what the community of learning looks like as you focus on inclusion. The community, the collaboration, the communication, that is the essence of our project here.
Our first field exercise took place at the Cliffs of Kilkee, where students had a chance to practice data collection with digital field notebooks.
Documenting using technology. Instead of a notepad that can get wet, they're using technology to take photographs, audio, sketches, and all sorts of things to document where they are.
The next morning, students shared and discussed what they found with the group. Back on the road, we head north along the Wild Atlantic Way to the town of Clifton. Our introduction to the geology of the area is a behind-the-scenes tour of the quarry that produces Ireland's famous green Connemara marble.
Nobody's ever seen this before, so you never know what you're going to get. And we try and get full course if we can, but due to the rocks, these cracks are in it, and you just pull up with what you get.
At the quarry, we meet Dr. Martin Feely, who has studied the geology of the Connemara region for 40 years. After the quarry visit, Dr. Feely introduces the students to the area where they will be conducting geologic mapping exercises in the days ahead.
The area that we chose along the old railway track was an ideal location. It's one that we use every year. And here we were able to use the railroad, the old rock canyons that were cut out, and to inspect, and for all of the students, mobile and less mobile, to come along and put their hands on the outcrop, able to use technology that I've just seen for the first time in the field, really, at such a general level, dealing with the iPads, measuring dip and strike, taking photographs, communicating between each other's groups by the lakeshore, groups on the road, all working in unison. Very, very good indeed.
This connection between team members is made possible through the use of a portable wireless network, which allows devices within the field site to stay connected to each other, even where internet access is not available.
Today we're using a local wireless network to connect up students that are spread across this site. So on the local network, we've got video streaming between the iPads, we've got photographs that can be shared, and we're using walkie-talkies to keep people in audio. And that duplication of technology makes us a little bit more resilient for any failures within any one of those tools.
While the road provided full access to some outcrops, the combination of rock and bog made the rest of the field site far less accessible.
Yeah, look at this. If I stepped here.
This is where mixed ability groupings really shine.
If the sheep can do it, so can I.
That's what I'm thinking.
Through the use of wearable cameras and tablets, these students share their experiences with their teammates back on the road with a first-person vantage point that illustrates the highs and lows of field work in this challenging terrain.
It's all good. Man, they're really gonna love my camera.
Guiding the students through this unique landscape were Drs. Eric Pyle and Steve Whitmeyer, who bring their students to this field site every year.
The students have essentially become experts of their own field site, and tonight they'll go back and they'll actually complete a map with the data from both sites.
So you can see how the technology is extending what they could possibly do if they didn't have the technology. And they're enabling them to do things and be professional geologists to the utmost level with the technology.
Our last field location put the idea of access through technology to the ultimate test and required a unique approach to field work. Renvyle Beach is located along the glaciated coastline of County Galway. With no accessible route to the outcrop and windy conditions, the less mobile students would have to stay inside the vans for communication to work effectively, and their only means to conduct field work would be through the remote link with their teammates.
Followed by thinning and silty material in the middle and then back to larger. Are you seeing that?
That makes sense too, because as the glacier retreated, there was all the fluvial activity from like the outwash plate.
Through the use of streaming video and photo sharing, teams were able to work together in real time to study the geology of a location that would have traditionally excluded participation for students with mobility limitations.
There's a lot of different things that come out of this, but essentially it's the communication piece that's most important. It's the social aspect where the learning takes place, and it's finding a location where students can participate at the level of their abilities, and that's what we've been able to accomplish here.